Hey there, everyone. Jonathan Silva here from Pragmatic Works. What I want to do is talk more about Copilot Studio, specifically here, how topics work inside of Copilot Studio. Now that we have some new generative AI options to work with and what that means for your traditional topics compared to new ones that you want to create. So here we have a bot that I've created just called Copilot Studio 101. And if I navigate over to the topics center, this is where we could see all of the different topics or different custom conversations that we can have within the Copilot Studio experience or the bot that we create experience that is going to interact with your general user. We have within our topics, our custom topics, our greeting, our goodbye, start over, thank you. I've added this need assistance one in here to take a look at in a second. We also have some lesson topics in there to like essentially learn from. What we also get are some built-in system topics as well. These are things that come with the bot that allow us to either start off the conversation here of the hello experience, and you can customize that message, or you can also have your conversational boosting of working with some generative answers that are created and some of these others that you could see here. And all you need to do if you ever want to customize any of these is just to click on it. And when you click on one of these, you'll see that we have a trigger statement that comes with our topic. In this case, for the trigger for the on conversation start, that's what's going to essentially be the welcome message to anybody that's using the bot for the very first time. And I can click down in here and you can see the message that I've curated, where it just simply says, hello, I'm insert the bot name. That's a variable. So take a look at a future video for that one. A virtual assistant. How can I help you? It's actually the exact same message that you see down here. I've named the bot Copilot Studio 101. There it is, our variable for Copilot Studio 101, the bot name. So that's what we're seeing in there for that topic. What we can do is we can select topics here at the top to navigate back to our topics that we were just in. Or if you want, you can use the drop down here to go through all the topics that are available specifically for this chatbot that we are creating. If you ever create your very own custom topic, what you can do, like let's see here, I added one called need assistance. What you can do is you can design your very own trigger phrases so that your user, whenever they say one of these phrases or something very close to it, the bot knows this is the conversation that we're going to take from this point forward. So if I select edit here, you could see the trigger phrases that I've added in. We should usually have between 3 to 5, even maybe 7 to 10 trigger phrases in here that would help the bot know, okay, it's going to recognize this word that we type in, and then it's going to go ahead and utilize the next steps. Within our topics themselves, we also get different nodes that we can add in. A node is, if I select this plus icon here, one of the different actions, if you will, that we can take, or steps of the conversation or the topic that we can take that happen after our trigger or anything else we add in. We can send a message, ask a question, initialize an adaptive card, add a conditional statement, work with some variables. We can even go to other topics or end the topic or skip steps if we want. Call actions here that work with both plugins and actions. And also there's some advanced ones here as well. So all of these are going to allow us to do something inside of the bot conversation or the topic that we're working with. For this one that I have that I'm calling need assistance, if the user comes in and says help, or I need help, need assistance, find, or classes, or something that occurs here, the first thing that's going to pop into them in the conversation is this question. Please select what you would like assistance with. It's sent as a message, but it's really like a question as well. And then I have multiple choice options passed into there for them. So if they have any questions about, say, Pragmatic Works, they can talk about the company information or some of the products that we have or trainers that we have, or just get in contact with customer service from there based upon whichever option they choose. And you can see our conditional statement then puts out 4 different condition types and our branches, plus an all other condition just in case none of those were selected. And we can go down the path from there. We can also have a redirect or end of conversation at the end. So once we're done with this, it'll then pop to a different topic as we go through it. In fact, if I want to test how this topic works, we can come over here to the right-hand side in our test your Copilot area and refresh this. And what it's gonna do is gonna start with our conversation start. There it is. Hello, I'm Copilot Studio 101, a virtual assistant, how can I help you? I can then add in one of these trigger phrases. I can just pick one here, like let's just say help, hit enter. And then what it's gonna do is tell me, okay, here's the next step. And in fact, I can see it going through the steps there. There's my check mark of it's actually on this action. Then from there, we can come in and choose one of these options, company information or product offerings, or any one of these. Maybe I'll choose product offerings. And then I can get a list of things that we at Pragmatic Works do to help out all of our clients or customers. And then you could see it's noticed that we've gone down one of these paths for our condition. And it's giving us this redirect, which is, did that answer your question? If I say no, it's gonna prompt me one way or another. And then I'll also, if I say yes, it's gonna do the same. In fact, it's gonna jump over to that other topic that I'm using for this to be able to see, okay, what's the next step? I can rate my experience, 5 stars. And then I can get my thank you for my feedback. Is there anything else I can help you with? And if I say no, then end of conversation. So the way that topics work, and they can jump back and forth between topics, the way they work here within Copilot Studio and the bot that we are building, it is allowing us to design the different conversation that we have. So with the different questions and answers and redirects and things that we want to have with our customers or our users of the chatbot when they're working there. Now, this is all the way the classic experience with Copilot Studio has been. In fact, back when it was Power Virtual Agent, it was still the same thing. What we now have within Copilot Studio is the introduction of generative AI, which means that these topics work just a little bit different. To enable that generative AI, I can go over to settings and then navigate over to generative AI in the left-hand side. By selecting this and turning it on, yes, it's still in preview, but it still works. I can enable generative AI, and what it does is it uses the AI experience to help us trigger our topics rather than directly using those trigger phrases. So instead of adding in specific trigger phrases, what we can do is we can essentially detail or explain what the topic is meant to accomplish, and then the bot will automatically, based on that explanation or based on those details, determine if that is the actual path it needs to take inside of the conversation. So now that the change is saved, I'll go back to my bot itself. If I go to my need assistance topic here, you can see that it is now, I don't have any trigger phrases triggered by Copilot. If I select edit, it's just triggering by Copilot itself. There's nothing else to do. Then what we need to do is describe what the topic does. This tool can handle queries like, I need help, need assistance, find classes. I can add more in, products, details, supports, add more things. I can even put this in plain text, put in a block of text and describe the whole purpose of this topic within the conversation. And it does really well of being able to identify, okay, where are we within the experience, the conversation with the user, and which topics do we need to cover from there? And it can jump back and forth between the different ones as necessary because of that generative AI. So I'll go ahead in here and save this and then refresh my test Copilot experience to be able to see, okay, is this actually working the way I want? In fact, what I can even do right next to the refresh option is I can turn on our conversational map. And what this will do within the conversation map is if I jump between different topics, it will show that I'm moving from one topic to the next. So let me go ahead and try this again. There it is, there's our conversation map here in the beginning. Can I help you? I'll just say, I need help. And there you go, it's automatically identifying that we are working with the need assistance topic. It could see here that, oh, that's the topic we're working with. It's now telling me which options we have part of that same conversation. If I wanted to come in here and choose company information, I could do that here. And you'll see that's now navigating through the rest of the topics themselves. If I have, did that answer your question? And I select yes, What it's going to do is it's going to continue on the same path that I have. I'll just choose a number here. Can I help you with anything else? You'll see the context is all being built by Copilot. Is there anything else I can help with? Yes. Go ahead. I'm listening. And then we can start the conversation over once more, or we can go to other things, or maybe say hello, maybe see what else, where else that takes me from here. And it's just going to try to map whatever the user has to try to point to the next piece. Now, I haven't developed this much further, so it's not really quite sure where else to go because I haven't made more topics. But as you develop more topics and more conversation maps here, the essentially a path to create, what it's gonna do is enable you to have a better experience with your end user to help them go ahead and get this bot experience done really well. So as you work with Copilot Studio, one of the great features that we can enable here is conversation or generative AI, which then lets us utilize our classic topic experience, but just making it a little bit nicer. And what it also will do is it will help us respond to the user by using that generative AI much more so that the conversation between the bot and the user isn't so static. It can be more dynamic. It can feel more like you're talking to an actual individual, even though it is the bot itself, rather than whatever key phrase that I type in with the message. It's definitely something to take a look at moving forward as we get more and more features pushed into Copilot Studio here into the future. If you like this video from me and want to see more information, not just about Copilot Studio, Power Automate, Power Apps, Power BI, and the rest of the Power Platform, definitely go ahead and check out pragmaticworks.com. Take a look at our on-demand learning platform to see all the things that we can offer for you to help you grow as an individual and as a company. Definitely check out what we have to offer for our courses online so that you can go ahead and level up your skills right away so that you can go ahead and accomplish whatever tasks you have in front of you that much faster and you're ready for the next step in your career.